You know that in exponent notation, we are trying to find the power. The exponent tells us how many times we are multiplying the base together. The result is called the value, or the power, of the base. Logarithms are the inverse operations of exponents. In logarithms, instead of finding the power, we are finding the exponent. Let's compare the notation of logarithms and exponents. In logarithms, we notate the base as a subscript next to the log. Then, we put the power next to this. The solution to the logarithm is the exponent. For example, here we are finding the logarithm of 16 with a base of 4. What exponent of 4 equals 16? Well, if we multiply 4 together 2 times, 4 to the power of 2 is 16. So the answer to this logarithm is 2. If we rewrite 16 as 4 to the power of 2, now we can see it clearly. 4 to the power of 2 equals 4 to the power of 2, 16. Now, by default, logarithms are base 10. So if you just see log, the answer will be the exponent needed to raise 10 to the given power. If we just saw log of 1000, we know that this is a logarithm with a base of 10. What exponent should we raise 10 to make 1000? Well, 10 raised to the third power is 1000. So the answer to this logarithm is 3. Now, sometimes instead of log, you may see ln. This means the natural log, which is just a logarithm whose base is Euler's number, or 2.71. The natural log is used a lot in science and calculus, especially in continuous growth problems like population or interest. The natural log works just like other logarithms. If we take the natural log of e to the power of 5, we know that the answer is just 5. To make things clearer, you could rewrite the ln as the log with the base of e. Obviously, e must have an exponent of 5 to make e to the power of 5. Okay, now all of this is cool and interesting, but why are logarithms useful? Since logarithms are the inverse operations of exponents, we can use them to solve tricky equations. For example, if we have this equation, 2 to the power of 2x equals 2 to the power of 4 plus x, it may be pretty confusing at first and seem very difficult to solve. But here, since both sides have a base of 2, if we take the logarithm of both sides with a base of 2, since the bases are the same, now we are left with just the exponents. 2x equals 4 plus x. And now, it's easy to solve. Just subtract x from both sides, and boom, x equals 4. And we can check our work. If we put in 4, we get 2 to the power of 2 times 4 equals 2 to the power of 4 plus 4, both of which equal 2 to the power of 8. So we found the right answer. Now, can you solve this equation? This may look very confusing at first, so let's break it down. The logarithm is telling us to find an exponent of 4 that equals 20. Let's label this unknown exponent as n. Now n is the solution to the logarithm of 20 with a base of 4, which we don't know. We are trying to find 4 to the power of n. But wait, we know that n is the exponent of 4 required to make 20. So this means the solution is 20. Because exponents and logarithms are inverse operations, if we raise an exponent to the power of a logarithm with the same base, the solution will be whatever is inside the logarithm function. How cool is that? Logarithms are super useful to learn and master, as they make simplifying equations with exponents a lot easier. So now, you know what that log button on the calculator does. And if you enjoyed this or learned something, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and share it with a friend. As always, keep working hard and keep learning. Thank you for watching.